Hi, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about how do EMFs or EMR, electromagnetic radiation, affect our bodies. So this is definitely a concerning issue for all of us because we are inundated with so many different sources of EMFs, and that electromagnetism, whether it's from our devices, from 5G towers, from our Wi-Fi routers, even from something as what we would think is a healthy thing, baby monitors to monitor our children, give off EMFs and can be very damaging to ourselves, which is something that I'm going to talk about. So thanks for joining me today. Make sure that you subscribe and click the bell. Also leave your questions and comments below, and please give me a big thumbs up, especially watching to the end of this video, because I know that you're gonna love the information that I'm sharing. So let's talk a little bit about the physiology. So what's happening? What is the problem? How are the EMFs actually affecting our cells? Well, there's something that has been discovered called a VGCC, a voltage-gated calcium channel. And what this means is that when these VGCCs open up, they allow for calcium to flood into our cells. And that's something that I'm going to demonstrate. I'm going to draw this out for you so you can get a bit of a visual as to what exactly is happening. So here, if we take a look at a cell membrane, the VGCCs are on the outside, and these are more concentrated in some tissues. So what they do is they allow for calcium to come into the cell. And a little bit of calcium is okay, but certainly too much is a problem and is very damaging to our cells. And what can happen is that when too much calcium is coming in, it can actually damage the outer cell membrane, but it can also damage other organelles. And one of the most important ones is the mitochondria. And this is where our cells make our energy or our ATP. And that calcium influx into the mitochondria can really damage the mitochondria. So this, the other problem with the VGCCs is that what happens is it allows for something called nitric oxide and superoxide. So high superoxide and high nitric oxide together form something which is very dangerous to our cells called peroxynitrite. So I'll write that out, peroxynitrite. And peroxynitrite has a number of very damaging properties to our cells. So not only does it damage cell membranes, but it is also very damaging to the proteins, to our mitochondria, and also to stem cells, and can actually damage our DNA. So this damage to the mitochondria, of course, can cause cellular death, but also less ATP production. And ATP being the energy that our cells need and our body needs to function optimally is a big problem. So if you have suffer with lack of energy and headaches and things, this could be because the mitochondria are actually becoming damaged in this whole process of the EMF exposure. So how do EMR affect our bodies and this radiation from the electromagnetic fields? Well, this influx of the calcium into our cells definitely affects different organ tissues that have a lot of the VGCCs to allow for that influx. So things like our muscles. So it can affect our muscle contraction as well as the heart. So the heart has a high concentration of the VGCCs, and this can cause arrhythmias because, again, with too much calcium getting into the heart can cause this imbalance in the proper functioning of that heart muscle and affects the electricity. And we know that the heart is electric, it has a pacemaker, and that can have a negative impact and cause the arrhythmias and even a heart attack, as well as the male genitalia. So when we talk about fertility issues being definitely related, not only in men, but in women as well, and the male genitals have a large number of these VGCCs, and again, that influx of that calcium definitely affects the fertility rates. our eyes as well. So I have an example of an eye model. And when we talk specifically about the lens of the eye, so the lens of the eye, of course, can be very sensitive to that EMF radiation. And cataracts can form in the epithelial layer of the lens of the eye. And the lens is what concentrates that light and allows for the brain to receive that message via the optic nerve in the eye. Now, if this lens becomes very clouded, that would be a cataract. And that's exactly what researchers have found, is that that EMF radiation causes that clouding of that epithelial layer of the lens of the eye and causes cataracts, as well as nerve fibers. So nerves have something called a myelin sheath on the outside, and this is a fatty layer. So it's comprised and is reliant on DHA, but also vitamin B12. And to maintain that fatty layer, that myelin sheath, this helps to allow for that proper conduction of those nerve signals in the nerve bundle. Now, that's why DHA is so important, because in a DHA deficient state, so you're not getting enough DHA, our body does not create DHA, what happens is that your myelin sheath becomes compromised and becomes super sensitive to that EMF radiation and can damage the nerves. So, you know, end stage of this is called MS, but it is very preventable. So by maintaining your DHA levels, but also minimizing your exposure to the EMFs, is super, super important for protecting your nerves and your nervous system. So in this study, we can see that there's definitely been a correlation between the myelin damage and deterioration with the exposure to RF and EMF exposure. So important to know that, yes, this has been studied, and we have to do whatever we can to protect ourselves and to protect our neurons, and especially that myelin sheath, from that EMF radiation. Now, when we talk about the brain, so the brain, we know definitely studies have been done and have been proven, especially with cell phone use, that that close proximity of the cell phone with the brain, and they've studied with, you know, whatever side of the head the cell phone has been carried on in the subjects in the studies, that's where, of course, the gliomas were demonstrating. So glioma being a specific brain cancer related to cell phone use. So yes, the literature and the proof is in the pudding. There's been over 1,200 different studies that have been done on EMFs and electromagnetic radiation and the negative impacts that have been proven in the science to be related to our health in a negative way. So something to think about. And yes, the information is hidden. You're always not going to hear about it or read about it. But if you do your digging and you do your research, you will find the information is there. As well as the effects on our neurotransmitters in the brain are affected by EMFs. So whether that's because of, you know, sleep disorders and insomnia are definitely related to that cell phone use, but also to Wi-Fi in the home. So that's something, again, with protecting our brain, important that we're doing that and using some of the tips that we have in other videos as to how to decrease your risk, but also specific things that you can do and take, whether it's supplementation or things in your diet. Check out those other videos here on YouTube and on social media as well, so that you get that information as to how to protect yourself, even if you can't get away from that EMF exposure. Things like anxiety and depression have definitely been linked to EMF exposure, as well as in children, autism and ADD and ADHD. So again, the literature proves that again, that inundation of our cells, and again, because of all of that calcium flooding into, whether it is the brain, the spinal cord, into our nervous system, damaging the myelin sheath of our nerves, definitely correlated, and something that we have to be, you know, cognizant of the fact that we have to protect ourselves, as well as the skin. So when the VGCCs open up and allow for that flood of calcium into our cells, this can have a negative impact on our aging process. So yes, you can age more quickly because of EMF exposure. So again, whatever we can do to mitigate that risk of aging more quickly, we'll definitely want to pay attention to that. And some people want to pay attention to that more than others. Another impact is on the microbiome and leaky gut syndrome. So it's been found that EMF radiation actually damages the tight junctions in the gut. And this is where leaky gut syndrome becomes an issue. So we want to maintain those healthy tight junctions, which we can see here on the left. But what happens with EMF radiation is that those tight junctions open up, they become damaged, and allow for microorganisms and toxins and, you know, regular foods that have not been properly digested to come into the bloodstream, and now inflammation ensues, as well as a reaction of our immune system, because it starts to react to these things that are passing undigested through the digestive tract and through those damaged tight junctions. So EMFs has an impact on leaky gut, and we see leaky gut, you know, the incidence of leaky gut is definitely on the rise. It's something, you know, that we didn't really talk about when I was even 20 years ago, but definitely on the rise. And we have to ask ourselves, well, what is different? What has changed? Certainly our inundation of exposure to EMFs is definitely, you know, on the rise as well. And now newly with 5G, that's a big issue. So we have to do whatever we can to protect ourselves. Also, the EMFs have a negative impact on Candida. So Candida is that organism in the gut. We all have a little bit, but when it becomes, you know, invasive and overgrows in the gut and becomes more of the fungal form, then we have a lot of problems. And some of the symptoms of Candida include a white coating on the tongue, craving for sugar, brain fog, gas and bloating, and, you know, the inability to get rid of that. And it's usually, you know, very pervasive. It doesn't leave easily. Yeast infections, ear infections, sinus infections are all related to Candida most times. And it's something that we definitely have to be, you know, wary about. If the initial insult was the EMF radiation, who would have put those things two and two together? So something to think about. Another study has shown that in terms of the microbiome, that the EMFs have actually made the bad bacteria more resistant to antibiotics. So we see in this study that exposure to RF EMFs in a narrow level of irradiation has made microorganisms, specifically E. coli and another bacteria, resistant to antibiotics. So what does that say? Yes, this, you know, there's definitely this impact that, again, not a lot of people are talking about, but we really have to make sure that we're protecting ourselves. And it's one of these unseen forces that has such a negative impact on our overall health. And what's interesting too is that the gut flora actually talks to one another. So they communicate with one another, either in a positive or a negative way. And it's not just chemically as once thought, it's also electromagnetically. So when we have, again, we're inundating the gut flora with that, you know, not natural, so non-native EMF, then that is definitely a problem. And also EMF reduces the number of our good bacteria, so probiotics, and increases the bad. So we've got a bad situation going on here with that EMF exposure. So thanks for joining me today. I hope that you give me a big thumbs up. Make sure that you subscribe to this channel and turn on your notifications so you get all of our new videos that we upload and you get them right away. Be sure to leave your questions and comments below. I look forward to hearing your questions and your comments. I would love to hear from you. And if you've got, you know, ideas for a future episode, please do let me know. I would love to hear what you're thinking about and what you're researching, and I'll do my due diligence and I will make a video just for you. So thanks again. I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and make sure to always take care of your good health and do it naturally.